In approximately a billion years, Earth will no longer be hospitable for life as we know it, necessitating the search for a new home among the stars. This impending reality ignites the innate human desire to explore, a trait that has propelled us across the most unforgiving terrains of our own planet. From navigating the dense jungles, discovering new species, and establishing habitats in the heart of wilderness, to braving the eternal ice and silence of Antarctica, humanity's spirit of exploration knows no bounds. The early 20th century marked the era of adventurers who, with rudimentary gear, ventured into unknown territories, showcasing human resilience and adaptability in the face of extreme conditions. Today, our ambitions stretch far beyond Earth's confines as we gaze into the night sky, wondering about our place in the cosmos. Mars, with its red allure, has long captivated our collective imagination, posited as humanity's next step in our cosmic journey. However, the dream of colonizing Mars is increasingly recognized as an insurmountable challenge, fraught with obstacles ranging from its harsh environment to the technological leaps required to sustain human life there. This realization has shifted our focus towards a more enigmatic and promising celestial body, Titan, Saturn's largest moon, with its thick atmosphere and surface lakes of liquid methane, offers a new beacon of hope. Unlike the barren and inhospitable landscape of Mars, Titan presents a unique set of advantages and challenges, reigniting our quest for a second home in the universe. This introduction lays the groundwork for a deeper exploration of humanity's potential future homes, highlighting the critical shift from the Martian fantasy to the promising possibilities Titan offers. The allure of Mars as humanity's next abode is rooted in its seemingly Earth-like qualities and proximity, making it a prime candidate for colonization in the eyes of dreamers and scientists alike. This fascination is not new. It spans centuries, fueled by early astronomical observations and, more recently, by robotic missions that have painted a detailed portrait of the red planet. However, the vision of Mars as a new frontier for human settlement is increasingly clashing with the cold, hard facts of its environment, leading to a reevaluation of its viability as a second home. Mars's environment presents a litany of challenges that make human habitation precarious at best. The planet's average temperature hovers around a bone-chilling negative 80 degrees Fahrenheit, far from the temperate conditions necessary for human life. Such extreme cold is just the tip of the iceberg. Mars lacks a robust atmosphere, possessing only a thin veil of gases about 100 times thinner than Earth's. This not only fails to retain heat, but also offers minimal protection against cosmic and solar radiation. The Martian surface is bombarded with radiation levels that would be lethal over long-term exposure, presenting a significant hurdle for colonization. Envisioning a scenario where humans attempt to colonize Mars brings these challenges into sharper focus. The first settlers would need to create habitable conditions from almost nothing, constructing airtight habitats to maintain the necessary air pressure and oxygen levels, alongside managing extreme temperatures, would be an immense technological and logistical feat. These habitats would need to be self-sustaining, equipped for agriculture, water recycling, and shielding against radiation, a tall order on a planet where resources are scarce. Moreover, the idea of transforming Mars to make it more Earth-like, known as terraforming, faces significant scientific and technological obstacles. Proposals have ranged from melting the polar ice caps to release CO2 in hopes of thickening the atmosphere and warming the planet, to deploying nuclear explosions for a similar effect. Yet, these ambitious plans overlook the massive scale of intervention required and the uncertain outcomes. The Martian atmosphere's composition and the planet's lack of a magnetic field complicate these efforts further, as they do not support the retention of a thicker atmosphere or offer protection from solar winds. In sum, the dream of Mars as humanity's new frontier confronts the harsh realities of its environment. The combination of extreme cold, inadequate atmosphere, and high radiation levels, alongside the monumental scientific and technological hurdles in creating and sustaining habitable conditions, cast doubt on the feasibility of Mars colonization. As the dream of Mars begins to fade under the harsh glare of reality, our gaze shifts further into the cosmos, landing on Titan, Saturn's largest moon. Unlike Mars, Titan emerges as a surprisingly promising candidate for human colonization, offering a unique set of conditions that could support future human settlers. This moon, enshrouded in a thick atmosphere and rich in organic compounds, presents a stark contrast to the barren, inhospitable landscape of Mars. One of Titan's most significant advantages is its dense atmosphere, which is 1.5 times more substantial than Earth's. This atmosphere is mostly composed of nitrogen with methane clouds and a complex climate system, including methane rain and liquid hydrocarbon lakes. Such an atmosphere offers protection from cosmic and solar radiation, a critical factor that Mars sorely lacks. Moreover, Titan's atmospheric pressure is conducive to human habitation, potentially allowing humans to walk on its surface with just an oxygen mask and protective clothing, without the need for pressurized spacesuits. The moon's surface and subsurface are believed to harbor vast resources that could support a colony. Titan is rich in hydrocarbons, with seas of liquid methane and ethane that could be used as a source of energy. Beneath its icy crust, Titan is thought to contain water ice and possibly a subsurface water ocean, similar to those believed to exist on Europa and Enceladus. These water sources could be vital for sustaining life, providing drinking water and contributing to the production of oxygen and hydrogen through electrolysis. However, the journey to Titan and the establishment of the first human settlement present formidable challenges. The distance from Earth to Titan is about 1.2 billion kilometers, making the travel time significantly longer and more complex than a mission to Mars. Such a journey would require advancements in propulsion technology, life support systems, and the ability to sustain a crew for years in the deep space environment. Upon arrival, settlers would need to implement innovative solutions for energy generation, oxygen production, and agriculture adapted to Titan's unique conditions. The lack of sunlight at Titan's surface, due to its distance from the sun and thick atmospheric haze, necessitates alternative energy sources. Nuclear power, utilizing the abundant hydrocarbons as fuel, and possibly geothermal energy, could be key to powering the colony. Oxygen could be produced through electrolysis of water ice, while agriculture would need to rely on hydroponic or aeroponic systems under artificial lighting to grow food for the settlers. Beyond the practicalities of establishing a human presence on Titan, the moon offers exciting scientific possibilities. The complex organic chemistry occurring in Titan's atmosphere and on its surface might provide clues to the building blocks of life. The potential subsurface ocean could be a habitat for extraterrestrial life forms akin to the extremophiles found in Earth's most inhospitable environments. Exploring these depths could unlock secrets about the origins of life in the solar system and beyond. In conclusion, Titan holds a promise that Mars cannot fulfill. A combination of a protective atmosphere, abundant resources, and the potential for scientific discovery that make it a compelling target for human colonization. While the challenges are daunting, the rewards of establishing a foothold on Titan could be the key to securing humanity's future in the cosmos.